So today's project, we're going to clean the banks up on this pond. We're searching for a feed line and an overflow line. And I think I may have found one feed line over here. There's a 4-inch white pipe right here. There is no water coming in it, and that might explain why the pond has gone down quite a bit here, at least recently. The main job for today, though, was just clean the banks up nice and get rid of some of this vegetation and so on, so that we can plant some grass here. Thank you. collected. The previous owner was a hoarder, without a doubt. As a matter of fact, that barn, if when I swing over, you see that barn over there, that barn over there is completely packed to the ceiling, both floors, with junk. So we have a few roll-offs, and even the grounds, like within a stone's throw of this, that barn and that house, there wasn't a section of ground that didn't have garbage on it. Had Grunt's Move Junk actually come in here first. And I think they took about 15 or 18 30-yard roll-offs out of here just from the grounds. And as we cleared trees and poked around more with our equipment, of course we uncovered all kinds of more garbage. We're turning this essentially into a park space here. It's really, got a branch scraping on my window over here. It's really going to be a nice property here. There's two shallow dug springs. I'm gonna try and break this branch off here. There we go. There's two shallow dug springs right here, and we are going to try and run some water from one or both of those springs into the pond if we can. dredge it. So I'm sure this won't be the last of the grading, but we wanted to just keep the vegetation, get the vegetation back, and thank you. trees and giving that maple just as much opportunity to thrive as we can. Thank you. it's working good. I think what I got to do is, after I do this first pass, I'll have to back away from it, and then I'll finish off
the
top.
Pull it back a little.
Yep.
Well, you got plenty of holes to throw dirt in over here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. How's the mowing going? Well, I repositioned the camera. Hopefully all that footage I just took isn't useless. I don't know if it went down into the hole deep enough or not. So Zach and I have these Senna Tough Talk headsets to communicate with each other with. And boy, are we disappointed in those things, man. I'll tell you. They're great for, you know, hooking Bluetooth to your phone. If a phone call comes in, the noise canceling piece of the headset does make it nice and quiet, so your phone call's nice and clear, but we're supposed to be able to communicate with each other. And man, it's so frustrating that when he's in that skid steer, man, he can be 75 yards away and I lose him. So around the circle out, or this corner, I mean, out from the might have to do that afterwards. Thank you. Chris.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
I just want to let you know I put the two pumps and a hose on the well.
Oh, okay.
In case I'm not around when you need them.
Okay, cool.
I'm assuming one of them's going to work.
Yeah.
I've been sitting in the shed for at least 10 years. So.
Yeah, okay.
But they worked when I put them in there, so.
Okay. Well, we'll keep our fingers crossed.
Yeah.
One of them ought to work.
There is a third one up there if you want to, if you do.
Okay. In the sugar house?
Yeah, right in the sugar house on the shelf.
Okay.
And there's a transfer pump up there too. So.
Okay.
Okay.
There is some clay in here.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
There's a top layer of this 4 or 5 inches of this crap, but underneath it's nice clay,
that's
so.
Good. Water then.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice. Okay, I'll let you get back to work.
All right.
I'll let you know it's over there.
Okay, thank you.
Yep.